I couldn't make this fit without spending a lot of time with this grinding burr. So I just 3D printed these, and I've been running them on my truck now for about 16 months, and they seem to be holding up. I do need to print another set of them for the other side of the truck. Those haven't fallen apart yet. I'm still running the bored out polyurethane. I have a different shock mount on the front as well, and that uses what's called the L1 straight bushing. And I needed to make some replacements for these too, because these also have 5/8 inside, and I had to open those up to 3/4 inch to get them to fit the shock mount on the front of the truck. Just a while back, a friend of mine, he has a Mazda B2600 4x4 pickup, and it turns out Rancho used to make shocks specific for that particular vehicle. This was the front shock, this is the rear. I'll post the part numbers in the video description for these two. They made custom bushings for these shocks to fit the Mazda shock mounts, but now they've discontinued that specific shock. They still have the same length shock. It's got the straight eye on the bottom, it's got the pin mount on the top, it's the same length, everything's the same, except they ship it with that bushing in there. And it turns out the shock mount on the Mazda pickup is a little bit wider. So I think this was like around 36 millimeters, and this one's about 40 millimeters. So this one was pretty easy, and what I did was just modeled this L1 straight bushing, but made it into a split bushing. So it's got two halves like this instead of one solid piece, because these bushings, you end up almost destroying them if you try to remove them. I think he needs the same diameter, the 5/8 inch or 16 millimeter, but I can also print these. Like here, I printed this one with a 12 millimeter center bore. So this shock was not too mismatched. I mean, you could get by with that bushing, and then you could put a washer on this side and a washer on that side. But the rear shock, that's what was really different, because the rear shock comes with this, which is similar to this. This one comes with a 3/4 inch diameter like I need, but you can see it's much bigger. So the shock eye is bigger to fit this larger bushing. They tend to have those two and that one are their most common bushing types. On this end, the Mazda needs a 12 millimeter bolt, not 19 or 3/4 inch. And on this end, they need a 20 millimeter bore, which means you'd have to bore that out, which is really time consuming. I've been there and done that. The other problem is that the Mazda shock bushing is asymmetrical. So what we did with the 3D printer was we printed a ring or a spacer here out of TPU so that you can work with that offset mounting stud. So you just slide this over first, and then you slide the shock on, and then you put the washer and nut on this end, and it all fits together like that. So that way we could make a narrower bushing, because you see this bushing is too wide and the hole's too small. So we made a 3D printed bushing that's narrower, and then it has the offset piece to shift the shock over a bit so it clears the shock mount, and then comes with a larger center bore. And then on the other end, the Rancho bushing is too wide, and it wants a 12 millimeter bolt through there. Theoretically, you could sleeve this bushing. Yeah, so the problem with all the Rancho bushings is they're all made with imperial dimensions. So like I said, 3/4 inch, which converts to 19 millimeters, but that's not a standard metric tubing size. You can get 20, 18, 16, 14, 12, but not 19. I think this one was, that one's the 40. So this one and this one are the same width. This is the lower shock mount. The upper one, though, is, I think, 39. Yeah, so that one's 39 millimeters plus the 4 millimeter spacer to make it 43. And you can see that one's like 45 millimeters. So you would need to shave down one side of this to fit, and then you'd have to hog it out with a die grinder. And cutting polyurethane is pretty difficult. I've done a lot of it, and it is not fun. And the idea with sleeves, this is the Rancho shock mount stud they used to ship. So this stud here has the shoulder on this end with the nut, and that's what you can screw in to mount this to something. They have a washer that fits over the stud, so that's a 5/8 stud. I'll just put this one on since it's easier to work with. But you can see there's another shoulder on this stud, so that when you put the bushing over like that, you put that washer on, and then you put the nut, you won't over compress that bushing because there's a shoulder in there. Now, if you have just a plain bolt without a shoulder, that's where you need the sleeve, because you've got to put the sleeve on there to keep from over compressing the bushing. You would use something like that. So this is the L1 straight bushing that I made with a 12 millimeter diameter. Now this one you would want to use a sleeve if your bolt was like this, because there's nothing preventing you from over compressing the bushing. Sometimes you have like two ears that stick out, and the bolt goes through the middle of those two, and the shock is trapped in the middle there. Well, in that case, it depends. If those two ears are just thinner metal, you might need a sleeve in the middle to keep from bending those ears in. This is basically retrofitting some Rancho, these are the Rancho 9000s. Retrofitted the bushings to match the Mazda shock mounts. So these are basically the new Rancho shocks, but retrofitted to match the Mazda shock mounts, like the original Rancho shocks that used to come with the right bushings to begin with. We're gonna try these out on his Mazda B2600 pickup, and we'll see if they work. We might have to tweak the dimensions a little bit. We do the Bilstein shocks for the Volkswagen pickup. In that case, all we have to do is we just are changing the sleeve out. The shocks we use have a bigger sleeve, and it's too wide. So we make a smaller sleeve that's narrower that'll fit into the Volkswagen shock mount. The Volkswagen shock bolt is 10 millimeters. The sleeve is set up for a 12 millimeter bolt, so it ends up being real sloppy fit. So we just make a sleeve that fits the bolt that Volkswagen uses, instead of trying to work with the way the shocks come. The nice thing with Rancho is they give you all the dimensions, the compressed and extended length, and then they tell you this is an L1 straight bushing, and then the other end is, I think they call this a pin mount, and then this one is L3 hourglass. Yeah, if anybody tries any of these bushings out, leave a comment. I'm trying to just gather some information on how these hold up. How does TPU filament hold up over time compared to polyurethane? And yeah, so if you give these a try, post up how it worked for you and what brand of filament. I use the Ziltec TPU filament, but there's a bunch of other ones. The Ziltec is a little bit firm. I think they list it as a 95A. And I think these bushings are more like a 90 or a 92. They're a little bit softer, but a shock absorber, this is what gives you the cushion. The bushings are there just to allow for the shock to move around. Let me know if you try them, how they work for you. And as always, thanks for watching.